which was made successful by the efforts of many people. This is a case of Mondini's dysplasia with a cochlear implant, which was done in the year 2009 and followed up for 10 years and is still being followed up. Patient details: the patient is a male child who is now 14 years and is a resident of Hyderabad. Chief complaints: hearing loss and inability to develop adequate speech by the age of 2 years. History of present illness: mother noticed that her child was not responding to loud noises by 3 months age and failed to develop speech by 2 years. He was taken to an ENT hospital and was diagnosed to be having profound sensorimotor hearing loss. Since then, he started using a hearing aid but was not getting adequate benefits. Antenatal history: no history of consanguinity. There is a history of preeclampsia in the third trimester and the child was delivered through a cesarean section. No history of any other infections or drug intake. The child was preterm and of low birth weight. There is a history of single episode of juvenile seizure at the age of 4 years and no history of any other ear infections or trauma. Family history: elder brother was having similar complaints and is now using a hearing aid. On examination, the patient is conscious, coherent, cooperative, and all the vitals are within the normal limits. External ear, tympanic membrane, middle ear are normal. Investigations: brainstem evoked response audiometry showed no peaks at the highest intensity level of 80 dB. Otoacoustic emissions were absent bilaterally. Tympanometry showed a type of tympanogram. MRI brain and temporal bone was absolutely normal. CT temporal bone showed unremarkable cochlear turns, which were just 1.5 instead of the normal 2.5 turns, unremarkable vestibule and a dilated vestibular duct, suggesting a congenital abnormality of the inner ear. Differential diagnosis: sheep dysplasia, Alexander dysplasia and other aphasias. Provisional diagnosis: Mondini's dysplasia. No associations were seen with Pendred-Wardenberg or other syndromes. Management: cochlear implant was done through cortical mastoidectomy, posterior tympanotomy, cochleostomy, and then a stimulator, receiver and electrodes were inserted and the wound was closed in layers. Follow-up: the cochlear implant was fixed on and the patient was put on an audio-verbal therapy. The most astonishing thing here is that he was sent to a normal school and was doing really well. But 3 years later, he developed gradual hearing loss. This did not stop him from attending the school and still continued going to the school using a hearing aid. Investigations showed displacement of device, which according to many articles of famous universities was known to happen because of lack of stability. Though Mondini dysplasia patients are prone for the displacement of device, the cochlear implant was undertaken in view of the patient's future. A redo surgery was necessary and was done 2 years back, and the patient was again put on audio-verbal therapy. Now the patient is continuing going to the school with really good grades. An important thing which should be mentioned here is the effort of the mother in trying to make her child just to hear. It may seem a simple case to us, but in a family having a deaf child, a cochlear implant is really important. Thank you.
So we do that surgery also, this surgery, the outcome of the results are very good. So we do the the better year, you have to go for surgery.
How many spiral ganglia? How many, the minimum number of spiral ganglia that are necessary to do the popular implant surgery? You have to assess the number of cells, man. Brain cells. What are the number of spiral ganglion cells in the pocket?
Since you electrically stimulate the nerve directly, there's no particular number of minimum spiral ganglion cells in
the pocket. No, you need to have 10% of spiral ganglion cells. The normal population of spiral ganglion cells is doubled at 5,000. At least 10% of spiral ganglion should be survivable to benefit the common implant. So what is actual, how does it help? How does cochlear implant help the chair? What is the... What does it do?
Initially, the sound processor receives the signals and they code it into electrical signals, and the electrical signals are received by a receiver, which is...
What does it actually stimulate?
It stimulates the auditory nerves, spinal ganglion.
Dendrites.
It is dendrites and the spinal ganglion.